Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. In the last chapter, we have seen that TOC deals with mathematical models of computer science. In this chapter, we are going to start with a very basic model of a computer, which is called deterministic finite automata. Now, what is deterministic finite automata? It is a mathematical model having very restricted memory. Now, with this restricted memory, what this model can do? There are various real-world embedded systems which are examples of deterministic finite automata. In the presentation, I have listed down three of them. Let's see one by one. An automatic door. An automatic door will open and close based on whether the people are entering or exiting from the door. Now, how does the door work? In the door, in the front end and the back end, there are two pads attached to the front and back side of the door, and the door senses whether people are entering or exiting from the door. From the sensation which is being sensed by the sensor, the door will decide whether to open or to close. Now, there are two states of the door. One is an open state, the other is a closed state. Let's see the presentation. Now, states are here to represent what exactly the door remembers. The door remembers the current condition of input, that is, whether people are entering or exiting. Let's see the working. Suppose initially the door is closed and a person is entering. When the person is entering, it is being detected by the sensor. Now the sensor will give a direction to the door to open. This is called finite state control. The earlier state was closed, and as soon as the person is entering, the door is open. You can see in the presentation, there are various ways in which we can represent a deterministic finite automata. The first one is called the transition diagram. In the transition diagram, as you can see, there are two states, open state and closed state. From closed state, if it is sensed there is someone who is entering or exiting through the door, it will be open. Similarly, from opening, if it is sensed that the person who was standing near the pad is gone now, the door will be closed. So this is the working principle of an automatic door. Other than this, there are various examples like elevators or microwave oven and various other real embedded systems which are using deterministic finite automata to remember certain things in a very limited memory space. We have seen certain examples, real world examples of deterministic finite automata. Now, in terms of mathematics, let's see what is the definition of deterministic finite automata. Deterministic finite automata is a quintuple. That means it is made up of five components. They are represented using letters Q, sigma, delta, Q naught, and F. Now, let's individually see what are these components. Let's start with the first one, that is Q. What is Q? Q is a set of finite number of states. As we saw in the example, states are used to remember information. Whatever the deterministic finite state automata is remembering using the state. The only thing which remembers is the state. So the state is consisting of the memory part of the DFA. Let's see the second one, that is sigma. In case of computers, we know that we have various inputs, like various languages have various alphabets. Similarly, when I say a computing model, it will have something called an alphabet. Alphabet is the set of symbols which will be considered as the input to the particular system. So similarly, in this case, you can see in the case of an automatic door, the information which is coming from the sensor could be sensed as an alphabet. Now, given the automata in a particular state and there is some input which is coming, now the automata will process that particular symbol and switch its state from one state to the other state. For example, in the automatic door, it was switching from closed to open or from open to closed. Similarly, there is something called transition. Transition is basically the switching of state from one to the other state. The last two components, Q naught and F. Q naught means initial state, F means the set of final states. Initial state means whenever the mathematical model is initiated, at that moment, what was the state of that particular automata? In case of door, we can say that initially the door was closed, and as soon as people start coming, the door is open, and continuously now it is opening and closing depending upon the input. Now, final state. Final state means whenever certain processing systems are considered, there is something called final state. That means certain inputs are valid and certain inputs are invalid. Now, this is not the case of a door. We will see certain examples later which have final state considered. So we can say that final states are those states in which the input, if it ending, then that particular input is considered to be valid. Otherwise, the input is considered to be invalid. We have already seen what is a transition function. Now, when one particular symbol is given as an input, we can say the transition function switches from, let's say, state 1 to state 2. Now, instead of one symbol, if an entire string is given, continuously we are applying the transition function until we are not reaching the last symbol. The continuous recursive application of transition function is called extended transition function. You can see the mathematical definition of extended transition function in the presentation. Simply stated, it is an extended version of normal transition function. Now, instead of one single at a time, here in extended transition function, you are processing the whole string, and after processing the whole string from the initial state, wherever the final state is achieved, that will be the output of extended transition function. Transition function is represented using delta, and extended transition function is represented using delta star. The star means you have processed zero or more symbols. Let's see the mathematical definition of extended transition function. Let's say Q is a current state and empty string is applied, then the output of extended transition function is Q itself. Now, this is the base. Now, inductively, if you have to define, we have to define the inductive step of that extended transition function. So, delta star of some string WA at state Q could be processed as delta star of W followed by A as a last symbol. In the last chapter, we have seen the concept of a language. Now, here also, we have something called a language associated with a deterministic finite automata. Now, what is this? Deterministic finite automata takes a number of symbols, as we discussed, and it will process, and end of the day, you will get either a state which is final or a state which is non-final. Now, if your string is ending at a final state, we call that particular string is accepted by the automata, and if it is ending in a non-final state, we say that particular string is rejected by the automata. So, if we consider the whole sigma star, that is the set of all strings possible under the given particular alphabet, then there are certain strings which are accepted and certain strings which are not accepted. Now, the set of all strings which are accepted by a deterministic finite automata is called the language accepted by that particular DFA. You can see more mathematical definition on the presentation. With this, we are finishing this topic over here. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to Ikita channel and do subscribe. Thank you.